Hi students, welcome to our science class. Our chapter name is Skeletal System. In the last classes, we discussed about different types of skeleton. And today we are going to deal with the further topics. So today we are going to talk about the joints. Joints. In our body, there are number of joints are there. And there are different types of joints, so we will discuss about that joints. And actually, how we can define this term joints? How we can define? We can define it as the place where two bones meet. The place where two bones meet are called joints. The place where two bones meet are called joints. So this is the definition of joints. So the place where two bones are meet are called what? Joints. And in these joints there is having some strong tissues. There is having some strong tissues. Tissues to connect these two bones, and they are called ligaments. They are called ligaments. So how we can define this term ligaments? The bones are joined together. The bones are joined together with some strong tissues, and that is called what? This ligaments. So there are generally two types of joints. We are going to look which are the two types of joints. That is, there are two types of joints. The first one is movable joints. Movable joints. And the second one is immovable joints. Joints are classified into two. The first one is movable joints and the second one is immovable joints. What is this? Movable means, movable joints means the joints can be moved. It is very free to move. They are very free to move. And what about this immovable joints? This immovable joints means it is not possible to move these joints. It is not possible. Not possible to move. So there are two types of joints. Movable joints and immovable joints. This movable joints means they are free to move. And actually, why they are so free to move? What is the reason for that? The reason is that there is a fluid is present between the bones. There is a fluid is present between the bones. And that fluid is called lubricant. That fluid is called. That fluid is called lubricant. Now the question is, which are the joints which is not possible to move? There is an example for the joints which are not possible to move. That is the joints in our skull. That is the joints in our skull. We know we can't move all the bones in our skull. So the joints in this skull is immovable joints, which means that it is not possible to move. That is because when these are the bones, they are just connected. They are just interlocked each other. They are interlocked each other. That's why these bones are not moving. Oh, they are immovable. So, want to remember this example for this immovable joints. In this area, we just classified these joints into two, movable joints and immovable joints. The example for immovable joints is skull, and the bones in the skull are just connected with some interlock. That's why they are not moving. And for these movable joints, they are free to move, and in between the bones there is having a fluid, and that fluid is called lubricant. This is all about this area. Now we are going to classify the movable joints into four. Movable joints are classified into four. The first one is ball and socket. Ball and socket joint. So this is the first type of movable joints, ball and socket joint. We will study this in detail later. Now we have to look what is the second type of movable joint. The second one is hinge joint. The second type of joint is hinge joint. And the third one is that the pivot joint. Pivot joint. And there is also one more, the fourth one. The fourth one is gliding joint. There are four types of movable joints. The first one is ball and socket joint. The next one is hinge joint. The next one is pivot joint. And the fourth one is gliding joint. So there are four types of movable joints. Now we want to study these four types of joints in detail. We can look what is this ball and socket joint and where we can see this joint. I think we have to study. So we can move to that area. Ball and socket joint. We see these joints in our hips and shoulders. We see these joints in hips and shoulders. That means the bone present at our shoulders. So for these bones or for these joints, it is having a socket or hole is there. A hole or socket, and a bone is there in this hollow socket. So this can move in all directions. So in this ball and socket joint, the bones can move in all directions. Bones can move in all directions. And in your textbook, there is a neat diagram for this ball and socket joint. Just observe that. So this is about this ball and socket joints. So when we are seeing this ball and socket joint, we are seeing it in our hips and shoulders. And this is free to move in all directions. In this joint, we can see a round end of bone. Here it is the round end of bone. The round end of bone fits in the hole or socket of another bone. Here the round shaped or round end of the bone is just be there in the hole or socket of another bone. That's how we can move this bone in all directions. This is about the ball and socket joint. Now we can move to the next type, that is the hinge joint. Hinge joint. So this hinge joint we can see in our elbow, fingers, knees, toes, etc. So this hinge joint we can see in our elbow, fingers, knees, toes, etc. That means the joint we can see at this area. So that is the hinge joint. Here you can see a figure, and the bonds between this elbow is what? The hinge joint. So this is the elbow joint. This is one of the example for our hinge joint. Elbow joint. And now the question is it possible to move to all directions using this bond? No, we can only move to upward and downward. So we can move upward and downward. So using this hinge joint, we can only move to upward or downward. And this hinge joint is similar to the hinges in door. It is similar to hinges in door. What is this hinges in door? In the doors, you can see this door is joined with certain type of metal pieces, which is having so many screws. And actually this is what? This is the hinges in door. So actually this hinge joint is just acting like the hinges in door, which means that we can only move this to upward and downward. This is about this hinge joint. Now we can move to the next type of joint, and it is called pivot joint. Pivot joint. Where we are seeing this joint? We see this joint in our neck. We see this joint in our neck. Here you can see a diagram. The in between this skull and this vertebra, skull and vertebra, you can see a joint, and that joint is called pivot joint. Here that is the vertebra is connected, the first vertebra is connected to our skull with a joint, and that is called pivot joint. What is the speciality of this joint? How we can move this? It is possible to move upward. Next, it is moved to downward. We can move sideways. So using this joint we can move upward. This vertebra is not here. So this joint can be moved upward, downward and sideways. Downwards and sideways, which means that we can move this skull down, up and we can move sideways. That is about this fiber joint. And remember, where is this joint is present? That is present in our neck, and the proper location is that the joint between our skull and first vertebra. This is about the fiber joint. Now we have to move the last type of joint called gliding joint. Next joint is gliding joint. So you can see this joint in our wrist. You can see this joint in our wrist, ankles, and between any two vertebra. So you can see these gliding joints in wrist, ankles, and between any two vertebra. It means we have a number of vertebra, right? So these vertebra are connected with certain type of joints, and that joint is called gliding joint. And you can see it in angles. So here you can see a diagram, and the joint is there in its angles is what the gliding joints. And this is all about this sliding joints. And how we can move this? Is it possible to move to all the directions? Here we can move it to back to bend. That is, it can move into back to bend. Then we can twist it. We can twist it. Then turn at each joint. Here, you know, using this vertebra we can move, and so that's why we can turn at each point. Turn at each point, and actually this name is gliding joint, right? What is mean by this gliding joint? Actually, this joint is making possible to slide against each other. They are making possible to slide against each other, which means that for each bonds they are allowing to slide against each other bonds. So that's why it is called gliding joints. This is all about this gliding joints. You can see this gliding joints in wrist, ankles, and between any two vertebra. And that means we have number of vertebra, and this joint is there in between two vertebra, and it can move back to bend, it can be twist, it can turn at each point, and it is called gliding joint because it allows to slide against each other. And we can see this in angles. That means we can see this joint in between the angles bonds. This is all about the gliding joints. So today basically we explained about the joints, different types of joints. And first we said that this joints is what the in between two bonds meet is called what? The joints. And in these joints they're having some sort of tissues, and they are called ligaments. And after that we classified these joints into two: movable joints and immovable joints, which is one type of bone we can, one type of joint we can move it, and the other type is not able to move. And the example of not moving joints are what? The skull. And what about the movable? There are different types of movable joints, and there are, we studied about four types of movable joints. The first one is the ball and socket joint. Then the second one is hinge joint. The third one is pivot joint. And the fourth one is gliding joint. And we explain every joints, and you have to remember where we are seeing these joints. And these all things are enough for today. You please want to read your textbook 3-4 times. and we will meet in our next class.